Welcome to Fumbling Through Fishing Planet. I'm Sid. Today I'm going to teach you how to catch the unique Dolly Varden right here in beautiful Alaska. And we're over here at Angling Middle Earth. We're right on the spawn. And you're just going to want to walk over here. There's a couple of spots. Like, I know a lot of folks like right here. And I know a lot of folks really like you come over here and you cast right here and let it float down here. My favorite spot is clear the fuck down here. He's stuck up next to this rock right here. And then we'll show you some baits to use. Alright, so the times you're going to want to fish these guys. We'll start sunny. Oh, sunny I guess is 8 a.m. to about 7 p.m. And then your partly cloudy days, you're going to want to fish from 5 a.m. to about 8 a.m. and then again at 7 p.m. to about 9 p.m. and then on your cloudy days you want to fish from 5 to 10 a.m. is all. Alright, so for jig bait you're going to want to get like a 2-aught to a 6-aught. And then you're going to use some of these nymphs. These guys seem like they work pretty good. I was having the best luck on this brown one or this yellow and green one. Alright, and then your hard baits, you want like, I don't know, 4 to 6-aught. Pretty much any of these bad boys will work up to 8-foot. These two aren't so great, they're a little deep. This one here though, the 6-foot number 5, lemon yellow, that one is my favorite for catching these Dolly Varden. And then for spoons and spinners, I was having best luck on these number 3s, single spoons. They were working pretty good. Just doing a slow one speed, either like a twitch or just a straight slow, those work good. Same deal with these number 3 bullet spinners. With these two, why are you stacked funny? Anyways, with these two here, the silver, blue, rose, blue, just straight bring them in. And then with these two here, the beetles, you just want to do like a lift and drop or something. Lift and drop, stop and go, something along the bottom because this is where beetles live. And then your baits you want to use if you're going to use floats would be like your large minnows and your chiners. Those both work real well. Your shrimps will work okay. Your small minnows will work okay. And then if you're going to use your float and you're going to want your terminal tackle, I prefer the pear shape because it gives you a lot longer casting distance. And you'll want like a number 2-aught to a 6-aught anywhere in there. I think I probably run like a number 4-aught. Alright, so when you want to cast, you want to make sure you have around 50 inches of leader out, and then you're just going to do as short a cast as you possibly can right here, and you're just going to let her float down and around, and like you just leave your pole right here and let it float down and around, and eventually it'll like sort of turn at the end, and it'll float it down and turn, and it'll put it somewhere right over in here. And that's fine to just leave it there for a few minutes. I've caught plenty of fish which is just chill in there. Or reel it in and cast it back out. Either way it'll work fine, but we'll do a few casts, see what we can't wrangle up here. Alright, so we hooked up on one. Let's pull them in and see what kind of fish we got here. Alright, there you go, anglers. That's how you catch yourself the unique Dolly Varden. Good luck out there, and I'll see you next time.